In the comments section of one of my quantitative research videos, I was asked, how do you support your study relationship based on a theoretical or conceptual framework? That is a great question. There has been a large push from academic institutions and journals in recent years for the explicit use of these frameworks in research studies. Theoretical or conceptual frameworks are used to support research in many ways. More than one framework may even be used in your research. How they guide the development of a research study depends on your question and research design. Sometimes you need to know your theory before you begin your study, and other times it makes more sense to select it after data collection. I always tell my students that the research question should drive all of the decisions in a study. Keep in mind, however, that sometimes your question actually comes from the theoretical framework. If your research is about testing, confirming, refuting, expanding on, refining, or adding to an existing theory, then you need to be sure you know what it is before the study begins. And I would explain it in the literature review section of your paper. When you get to the results section of that paper, it would likely make sense to organize your results in the same way that the theory is organized. In the discussion section, you can then examine how your results and other literature either support or refute the theory. Sometimes you will not set out to discuss a particular theory. A theoretical or conceptual framework will still be useful to support your question or organize your findings. When using a theory to support your question, the theory needs to relate to the reason why you are doing the study. In Killam and Heerschap 2012, we used a theory about force field analysis to justify examining student perceptions of challenges to their learning in the clinical setting. Basically, the theory talks about how change occurs when positive forces outweigh negative ones. Therefore, if educators want students to be safe, we need to remove barriers to students practicing safely. In order to remove these barriers, we need to know what they are, and there you have how the theory supported the reason for asking the question. Quite honestly, we added this theory in after the study was completed, because the journal required that we have one. Our selected methodology, however, supported conducting the study without a theoretical frame up front. We developed our own model to explain the findings. The theory did work well with the discussion section that had already been written for the paper. I have done a few qualitative studies where I wanted to examine a topic broadly and have subsequently found a theory that helped me organize and explain the findings. For example, in Killam and Carter 2010, the ecological model was used to organize the findings of a literature review about challenges that student nurses face while on clinical placement in rural settings. We did not select the ecological model as a lens until after the review was completed and we were in the process of analyzing data. You can look at this article for free by clicking on the link below this video. Notice that the ecological model is introduced in the literature review, used in the findings section to organize the collected data, and again in the discussion section. Originally, we had used all the headings from the model in the discussion section, but due to space limitations, we had to condense it. When writing it up, we did link the selection of the framework to the question. You will find that if you select the right framework, the question and findings will fit nicely with it, and the entire paper will flow nicely, making it a high-quality product. If your research is designed to generate a new theory, it would make sense that you don't know what it is before you begin. So, you will want to explain the concepts you're examining in the literature review. In your findings, you would then build the case for your theory based on your study data. Then, in the discussion, you would talk about how pre-existing literature also supports your theory. Another use for theory is to explain the culture of the group being studied or the worldview of the researcher. In qualitative studies, it is useful to know these things when assessing the quality and transferability of the study. Sometimes studies will present a conceptual framework, which may include discussion of multiple views of a particular concept, like in Killam et al. 2012. The entire paper still flows because it is about one topic, but there is no clear pre-existing theory supporting the entire paper. What other ways have you seen theoretical or conceptual frameworks used to support study relationships? Do you think journals should require a theoretical framework in publications? Why or why not? Please share your views below. Thank you for watching. Be sure to subscribe if you want to be up to date with new videos as they are released. Feel free to ask me any questions that you have below, and I will do my best to answer them. Videos are posted on Thursdays as often as I can. Right now, I have a baby at home, so they are not coming out weekly, but hopefully in about February of 2014, they will start coming out weekly again. Thank you.